Two people, including a child, died when Taliban militants launched an assault on the Afghan parliament on Monday, triggering gunfire and the progress of the Sarv Siksha Abhiyan. At a high-level meeting, the Prime Minister reiterated his suggestion for Swachh Bharat, Swachh Vidyalaya competitions among various schools. The Prime Minister asked concerned officials to explore the possibility of a twinning arrangement between one class of a school in an urban area and one class of a school in a rural area. A day after the world celebrated International Yoga Day with nearly unprecedented enthusiasm, the government thanked the world community for making the day a grand success. Two-day international conference on yoga for holistic health was also organized in the national capital on the occasion. Addressing the valedictory session of the conference, Home Minister Rajnath Singh said, "Yoga can channelize knowledge into good work." Yoga education will be introduced in all central government schools from class 6 to 10th, and it will also be a training module in teacher education programs. Releasing the syllabus and course material for the students, HRD Minister Smriti Irani said the subject would not put any additional burden on students as 80 marks would be reserved for practicals. Supreme Court has issued notice to the Centre and Uttar Pradesh government on a plea seeking CBI probe into the alleged murder of journalist Jagendra Singh by setting him afire in Shahjahanpur district, in which a UP minister and five others have been booked. A bench of Justices M.Y. Iqbal and Arun Mishra asked the Centre and others to file their response within 2 weeks. A Delhi court has dismissed the bail plea of ex-Delhi law minister and AAP leader Jitendra Singh Tomar. With this, the court sent him to 14 days judicial custody in fake degree case. Court said allegations against Tomar are grave in nature as he is a public representative and an MLA. The retirement fund body EPFO has notified an order to make activation of universal account number mandatory for all employers. This move will benefit crores of private sector employees. Now an employee will have the same PF account number even though he may keep on changing jobs. For the first time, 43 Indian pilgrims, including 5 support staff, were escorted to China for Kailash Mansarovar Yatra through the 1400 feet high Nathula Pass, a new landmark of India-China friendship. After brief frisking at the integrated checkpost at the pass, the pilgrims were escorted to China where they were received by the Chinese officials. After making a slow progress, the southwest monsoon has advanced rapidly and is likely to hit almost the entire North India, including Delhi and the National Capital Region, in the next 2-3 days. The Met Department has said monsoon will also advance to Bihar, Jharkhand, Gujarat, Chhattisgarh and parts of Madhya Pradesh during that time. Belying predictions, the country has received 21% more rainfall than normal for this time of the year. An intense heatwave sweeping across Pakistan's southern Sindh province has killed around 400 people in Karachi. The heatwave has caused havoc and triggered an emergency situation in major hospitals of the province. The Sindh government has imposed a state of emergency at all hospitals, cancelling leave of doctors and other medical staff, and is increasing stocks of medical supplies. In Nigeria, 30 people were killed when 2 girls blew themselves up near a crowded mosque in northeast of the country. It is the 4th suicide bombing this month in Maiduguri, which is the birthplace of the Boko Haram extremist group. Boko Haram has kidnapped hundreds of girls and women, and the number of female suicide bombers has raised fears that it is using the captives in its campaign. The United States has said that it would contribute special operation forces, intelligence and other high-end military assets to a new NATO rapid response force that aims in part to deter any future actions by Russia. US Defense Secretary Ashton Carter made the announcement during a trip to Germany, where he delivered an address accusing Moscow of trying to recreate a Soviet-era sphere of influence. Greece's economy minister has spelled out the terms of new proposals to end deadlock on its debt crisis amid hopes a deal can now be struck this week. German Chancellor Angela Merkel said new proposals offered by Greece constituted some progress, but she said more work was needed and time is short. Greece must pay €1.6 billion to International Monetary Fund loan by the end of the month. If it fails to do so, it risks crashing out of the single currency. India's tour of Zimbabwe, which was scheduled for July, has been called off by the BCCI due to broadcast issues between the board and 10 sports, as well as to give players much-needed rest. It was reported earlier that a cloud of uncertainty prevailed over India's forthcoming tour of Zimbabwe next month, with the country's cricket board saying that the series could be postponed to next year. After winning the first match in the Hockey World League semi-final 2015, the India's men team is looking to register their second win against Poland at Antwerp in Belgium today. Both the teams will compete against each other to earn full points from the match.